English Primary School, Class 6, and the subject is English Grammar, and the chapter is 23, and the name of the chapter is Infinites and the Participles. Now we will see the what is the infinites and the participles. First we will talk about the what are finite verbs. A finite verb is a verb which has a subject also and it shows the tense also. That means it changes its form in order to indicate. That means it indicate a change in the tense. For example, we will see here, Sam writes the poetry and Sam wrote a poem. And Sam will write two more poems. That means it shows the sentences here. And in the slide, we can see the example, the Nana lives in Thailand. Here the subject, that means the lives, describes what the subject is showing. And leaves is a finite verb here. So if we will talk about the in short, it is a verb, being a verb, that is a doing verb, we can also say, as opposed to a non-finite verb, that means it is a verb. So in the finite verbs, it shows the information, grammatical informations of the gender or any person or any number, the tense also, the mood also, the voice also, and any aspects also we can see in the finite verbs. So here we have seen in the finite verbs, that means it changes the forms, that means it indicates the tense also. Now the next one, we will see the examples here. They play football, he plays football, you are playing football, she is playing football, she was playing. That means in all the things we can see the tenses is shown. Here the each verb has its subject, means each and sentences, in the each sentences, each verb has its own subject. And in the form of the verb, it depends on all its subjects only. And each verb is also limited with the number persons of the subject and its tense also here. So now the next one we'll talk about the non-finite verb. Verb, in the non-finite verb, there is no subject, no tense or no number. In the finite we have seen there was the subject and the sentences, it shows the tense also, number also, everything. But in the non-finite verb, it doesn't have no subject, tense or the number. It cannot make any complete sentences. It needs the help of the one finite verb to make the meaning. That means the non-finite verb is a non-meaning sentences. That means it doesn't make any complete sense. Whenever, when it takes the needs, that means help of the one finite verb, then only it completes the sentence. That means I too play cricket. See the example it is given, I too play cricket. That means here there is no sense, no complete sentences it is given. This is the example of the non-finite verb. And the same sentences we have added down the finite verb, that is the like. I like to play cricket. That means it gives the complete sentence. So this is the non-finite verb which helps, it gives the help of the one finite verb. So this was the difference between the finite and the non-finite verb. The same example we can see here, the non-finite verbs, they like to play, to play, playing, to play. These are the examples of the non-finite verb. But with the non-finite verbs, we have added the finite verbs also, because with the help of the finite verbs only, it gives the complete sentence. See, the to play means non-finite verbs. They like here word has given the finite verbs, means they like to play football. That means this like, likes, his, was, have, like. These are the finite verbs which connected with the sentences for giving the complete sentence. So next we will see the infinitive. That means an infinitive is the name of the certain verb that exists in many languages also, we can see it down here. That means in the usually if we will talk about in the English description, the infinite of a verb is a basic form. That means without the particle, the word it has been used to. Therefore, do, to do, be, to be, and so on. In this way, the word to has been added. That is the infinite verb. Now next we will see the example here. Now next one is the present participle. Present participle is a word that which always ends with the ing, and it is formed from the verb, and it is also used in an adjective or in a verb tense. So in the present participle, always we have to remember that it ends with the ing, and it is formed from a verb. From the verb only we are forming this present participle word, and in the sentences we will use the adjective also or the verb tense also. See, in the example it has been shown, the fleeing criminal, the word fleeing is ended with the ing, and the flee is the word adjective, to flee. That means everything is added here. Ing is also there, adjective word is also there in the verb tense form. He was, next example, he was waving his cutlass. That means the waving, the word waving, which ends with the ing, and the verb tense, if you will talk, it is the to wave. That means the wave is the verb tense. So in this way, in the present participle, we have used these things. Now next is the past participle. In the past participle is also formed from a verb, and it is also used in an adjective or the verb tense, but always is ends with the ed, d, t, e, n, and n. These are the things which ended the words in the past participle. It is the natural things which we have studied in the basic about the tense, that is a simple present tense, past tense, and the future tense. The simple tenses which we have studied in the previous thing. The same things here we have shown with the example with the added of the participles. That means ed, d, t, e, and n. That is, these are the past things. His painted skin, painted, ed, the word is shown as a past. And the paint, to paint, which we have added the adjective verb. And the same things for the forgotten also, t, e, n. That means e, n we have added. And the forgot means the verb tense here. Now the last topic, that is the regular and the irregular verbs. Now we will see what is the regular verbs. Regular verbs are those words which modify, and it modifies the sentences and it gives a complete meaning. That means here we are adding the word with the ed or d to the regular verbs to make the sentences as a past or the past participle. That means in the regular verbs, the sentence, that means the word is added ed or d, which shows the past or the past participles. But in the past simple and in the past participle of these verbs are the same. If we will talk about the past, because the ed and the d, which is always used in the past only. See the example, it is given normal word except the basic form. If we will talk about the simple past and the past participle, which is added ed, accepted, accused, banished, begged. So these are the words which ended with the ed, which shows the past simple and the past participle. And here is the irregular verbs. In the irregular verbs, they don't follow any regular verbs for adding the letters ed when making the past tense. That means here we will not follow any regular verbs. In the regular verbs, we have seen the word is ended with the ed, d. So here there is no regular verbs. Here we can see the some example. No, new, catch, caught, sleep, slept, feel, felt, buy, bought, get, got, think, thought. Means see, here the words has been in the irregular verbs. It is in the present and just we have converted in the past tense. Here also we are making the words in a past tense but not adding ed or d. So these are the difference between the regular and the irregular verbs. I hope so all the points are clear.